So you heard about the benefits of drinking nanoparticles for health and well-being. Then you realize that there are more than one way to do it. Which way is the best? Let's investigate that now. One of the questions I get asked quite frequently is, what do I start with? I'm new to nanoparticles. I want to start making nanoparticles, but I see that you have several different ways of making nanoparticles. We have low voltage DC electrolysis. We have the plasma arc set up. And now we have laser printed nanoparticles. So which one does a new person do? They want to get involved in making nanoparticles for themselves. They want to increase their health and their well-being. But what to go to first? And it's an interesting question. I mean, each method has its drawbacks and its strengths. Low voltage electrolysis is probably the most easily accessible in the sense that need a few pieces of equipment, a power supply, some beakers, a stirrer, and a heated stirrer if you want to make gold, and you can get started with low voltage DC electrolysis nanoparticles. Now the problem with low voltage DC electrolysis nanoparticles is you have to use chemicals in order to create the nanoparticles. All right, they're household friendly chemicals: citric acid, sodium citrate, NaCl, which is salt, but it's still not pure distilled water. And the nanoparticle count that you get from low voltage electrolysis nanoparticles is kind of low. You can expect something around the range of 10, 15 parts per million. There's some of the metals you'll be able to boost quite high, but other metals with low voltage electrolysis, that's pretty much all you're going to get. So the concentration is a little bit low, and you're going to get oxides in low voltage DC electrolysis. So it's not going to be 100% nanoparticles. Now the next thing is plasma arc. Plasma arc uses a 10 or 15,000 volt transformer. It creates an arc between the two metal rods, whatever it is you're trying to make. And that heat melts the wire, goes into the water, creates nanoparticles. That method uses only distilled water. It is one of my methods two methods I use these days. I use that and I use laser. But the problem with plasma arc is you need a 15,000 volt transformer. You have to be careful that you're not going to burn by the arc. And it needs glass tubes and rods, specialized setup to make sure the arc doesn't go all over the place. So plasma arc becomes a little bit out of reach for most people who just want to make nanoparticles. Now, the newest method that I like the best is the laser. The laser, again, only uses distilled water to make nanoparticles, and it's extremely stable. With laser, anything I put in the laser is stable. But the problem with the laser is it takes a longer amount of time to make the same amount of nanoparticles, and that depends on the strength of your laser, how many watts it is. Depends on the metal you're using, the melting point of the metal. The lower the melting point of the metal, the easier it'll be to make nanoparticles out of it. That doesn't mean that if your laser is not capable of melting the metal, you can't make nanoparticles. You can. Like in the case of palladium, I have an 18-watt laser, and palladium is so hard that it doesn't even dent the thing. You can't even see a mark on it with the laser, and so it takes quite a long time for me to get like 250 milliliters of palladium. Could take me 10, 12, even 15 hours in the laser. With the laser, you need the investment in the laser itself, the laser equipment. And you need the space to put it, and you have to be careful. Your eyes, you got to make sure you wear the glasses because the lasers can be dangerous to the eyes. So it's not without its problems, but I think by far the laser offers the simplest and the most efficient way of making nanoparticles. You get a 5 nanometer particle size as opposed to a 20 nanometer particle size with the other processes. And that body just loves the smaller particle size. It just absorbs right into the body. And people feel the effects from laser colloidals quite fast. So my choice of the three is laser. Yes. If I was new and getting involved in nanoparticles, I would go out and get at least a 10-watt laser. Hopefully a 15-watt laser or stronger if you could afford it. The cost of starting up with a laser, if you get a good deal on a laser, could be actually lower than the other two. Thanks for listening to me. I'm Tom, Alchemy Wizard. I will speak to all of you later.